Thank you. testing. Fade out as I settle in here. This is exciting, isn't it? Here we are. We're on twitch.tv. And now you'll notice the music stopped looping. I did that. Welcome, everybody. There's probably one person watching right now. Oh. It's funny you mention the death of Leo Gallagher, because at the very beginning of the stream, I accidentally hovered over, like, Windows 11 has this annoying thing in the corner where if you hover over it, it shows you a bunch of news stories that you don't want to see. Hang on, I meant to have the background TV going, because I just think it's cool to have something on the TV while we're doing this. You're not going to be able to really see what's on there. I don't think. I actually turned the brightness way down, because you couldn't even really like make out shapes or forms or anything like that. And hopefully, it would delight me to no end if you guys watching this somehow managed to guess what was playing on the TV. And it's not, there's some VHS boxes facing out, and it's not either of them. Just that's a clue. And it's not Quisp cereal playing on the TV. That's just a box. That's an empty box of Quisp cereal. And it has tax documents inside of it, because I decided to use it as a storage for tax documents. I accidentally hovered over the little annoying corner that shows you news stories, and I was bombarded with Comedian Gallagher's cause of death explained, which actually it looks like it was posted 5 hours ago. So this is old news. And let me read this. And finally, okay, all right. Now, he ran for governor in 2003 with the tongue-in-cheek slogan, "Finally a governor you can get drunk with." Gallagher continued touring during the COVID-19 pandemic. Oh, he struggled with poor health. He really was the maddest. Massive organ failure while under hospice care. Isn't that funny? Yeah. So, as a person of a certain age, Gallagher meant something to me. that's very funny. Gallagher, I watched his comedy because it was on Comedy Central. I remember sort of liking him. I bought a VHS tape of his. I think it was Melon Crazy, where his head was painted like a melon. And actually, I'm getting ahead of myself. I realized I think I was in 11th grade, and I went on a date with a girl, and it was very much I was being forced, even though I liked this girl, my mother was kind of trying to encourage me to do normal teenage things like go on dates. And so she like got us tickets to the Gallagher show because she knew that I sort of liked Gallagher. She probably witnessed me watching Gallagher at one point. And we went to the show, and I remember Gallagher was just out, fully bald. And he was like, for an hour before the show started, he was just chucking candy at people. And like playing stupid games like, hey, you in the back row, you try to catch this. And he's just throwing, like, he's just plying the whole audience with like Tootsie Rolls. And the show starts, and I'm this is kind of confessional, but a few weeks before, I had convinced my family to see Kids in the Hall. It was like the first reunion tour in like 2000, I think. And I remember Kids in the Hall. I remember liking it, and I loved the Kids in the Hall. I watched every episode of Kids in the Hall. But I remember feeling vaguely disappointed by the live show for whatever reason. I mean, I was glad I went. And then I went to Gallagher, which I had very low expectations for, and I remember like laughing so much more at Gallagher than I did at the Kids in the Hall show. And I remember having kind of a crisis about it, and because I had already had these very high-minded, pompous ideas about what good comedy was, and it wasn't Gallagher. And I couldn't believe how much it made me laugh. And then like thinking back, it was all just completely vile, you know, shit. The stuff that he gets a bad rap for now, he was doing then. Oh yeah, and I mentioned that he was fully bald because I think it was funny that he still does the bit where he reveals that he's bald, because he's wearing like a hat with fake hair on it, and then at one point he takes the hat off and scratches his head, and you see the hat hair is attached to the hat. He still does that bit even though he spent an hour in front of the audience like whipping candy at people. And you're not supposed to do that as a performer. And you know, some would say that my sweet tooth got the best of me, and I'm quite convinced that the girl I took to the show lost respect for me because of how much I laughed at the Gallagher show. I was not present for any of Gallagher's sets during the Bridgetown Comedy Festival. Had a good day, thank you. I get that reference. I remember that bit. I remember so like Gallagher went. He came to Portland during the Bridgetown Comedy Festival a few years back. Probably like, Jesus Christ, I don't even want to think about how long ago it was. It's probably way longer than I realized. And he like got on a bunch of shows, and he most, I think, notably went on the Andy Woods show. I think it was called Probably Science. And he was with Peter Serafinowicz. And I remember I listened to the podcast. I was not there. I did see Gallagher around, like walking the streets of Portland. He had a really cool jacket with like a scorpion on it, I remember. And I was like, oh, look at that cool guy. And then I realized it was Gallagher. I remember his big thing was he got scolded. Some might use the term woke scolded by Peter Serafinowicz. And Aqua Teen Forever, that movie, by the way, did not, I think it was, it might have been the jacket from Drive. That movie was not, I was at Movie Madness today, and it was not, they did not have it at all. But then I realized that might be a Warner Brothers thing, because when I worked at a video store, we had to sneakily purchase Warner Brothers movies. Even though video stores were and are dying, they still had a rule in place about selling new releases to video stores, because I think they were like exclusive with Redbox or something like that, maybe. But we would have to, when a Warner Brothers film came out as a new release, we would have to go to, not us, but the managers would go to Best Buy and buy them. And that's what they had to do. They weren't allowed to purchase them from Ingram, which is the big giant corporation that supplies DVDs to stores video stores and the like. Sorry, I was a few minutes late. I wasn't that late, but wanted to warm up my tea. And pee pee poo poo. Had to do some pee pee poo poo. So what we're doing tonight is, first of all, I want to get this squared away. Okay. We are going to, I hope, now I don't know, I don't know what you get in trouble for playing on Twitch. I don't know what that's like. It seems this snippet of Get a Life is okay. I have it muted because I don't want the go-go's to trigger some sort of thing. But Head Over Heels by the Go-Go's is the score for this little montage. And I'm basically am kind of just doing whatever and seeing what happens, because I'm curious. David Merkin misidentifies this song as Vacation on the DVD audio commentary. Just thought you'd like to know that. We're going to do a quick little tribute to Gallagher. This is something that I think about with Gallagher a lot, is this episode. I'm going to have to scrub through it. And I got to get the volume back. So, this is a later day episode, you can tell, because the theme is not iconic, not the iconic little tracking shot of Kermit going through the, why'd they have to cut out the commercial? Let's get to the right moment. We're not watching this whole episode.
Are you sure?
He's great. I always think about this moment where they, I feel like they're making fun of Gallagher here in this episode of Muppet Babies.
Are you kidding?
Because they're just showing babies laughing at him, and that's not really like the most flattering. Okay, we're not gonna watch the rest of this.
No.
That's real. I don't have that sophisticated of an editing suite. All right. Let's watch this classic.
Which is right over there on that mountain, and he's here in a flash. And then you put your straps around there, around the wheels, and here he comes. And when he comes by, I'll just throw that up there, and he'll catch a hold of it. And it's all now. Helicopters are already paid for by our tax dollars. We've got all kind of helicopters. We're the most technologically advanced society on the face of the earth. Why don't we use,
for a time, this was one of my favorite videos of all time. Like this, I would watch it every day, at least. It just makes it look like he hates cars. Like it's missing So I think the idea was that he was pitching this as something to do for if there was a terrorist attack and that involved a stalled vehicle on the freeway. Watch this.
No problem.
Then you get you on your cable.
No problem.
Then you take it, you put it on here like this. You take your big screw, you stick her in there like that. You screw up like this.
He could have made so many jokes right there, but he was being serious about this.
You see? Now you're ready to go. All right, now I've got all this together. So I just jump off and I tell my pilot that he can get out of there, and he takes that car out of there. That car's gone.
That car is gone.
It's gone. That car's here. It's gone. Get that car out of here.
Hated that shitty fucking car.
Oh, look. We've got the front end. But we can just lift it from the back end, and you got no problem. Take it away. This is Captain Gallagher.
Bonk.
Your wrecked problem.
That's fine.
I'm gonna solve. No problem. Skydeck. No problem. No problem. No problem. No problem. No problem. No problem.
Okay. So, yeah, that's my tribute to Gallagher, is me putting on that snippet of Muppet Babies and this clip of him hating cars so much that he went and got a helicopter to bail him out. It's like the movie My Bodyguard, but instead of a, you know, Matt Dillon, it's a car. It's a stalled vehicle. And instead of Adam Baldwin, it's a helicopter. And Gallagher is Chris Makepeace. And I don't know who, like, Ruth Gordon would be. This probably is how he would want to be remembered. Okay, so tonight what we're doing, this is my idea for a Twitch stream that I may or may not do depending on how tonight goes. On some kind of basis, some kind of regular basis. Tonight we're gonna watch, I have a playlist of every movie trailer from 2003 for each movie that I had seen. Does that track? I've seen a number of movies from 2003, and I've gathered the trailers for all of them. And I'm going to show you the trailers. We're going to talk a little bit about the movies, probably. I might go on tangents. And, hey, Brad Harity, hey, welcome, peace and love. That's what you're supposed to do, right? You're supposed to, like, say hey to people when they, like, sub and stuff. Anyway, I've gathered a collection of trailers. I don't know if we're gonna get through all of them tonight, but they're all for movies that I've seen and can probably say something about. And, I don't know, I might do this more with different years, different themes. I like watching movie trailers, and I think it's fun to talk about movies, and I think maybe getting together to watch trailers on Twitch might be a little bit of a, you know, might be like a fun or novel thing to do, huh? You know? And maybe I'll do other stuff. Like I could, you know, talk about my books. Welcome to my book collection. Right? Like that guy? Remember that guy? That guy went viral because he had the scary books? I forget. Forget who that was. I think that was, the rock and roll guy. But, yeah. We can, take a look at my books. My scary books. This. Yeah. was Danzig. It was not the Warren. Wait, who is the Warren barbershop guy? Oh, wait, is that? Okay, I barely remember that, but I think I know what you're talking about. Let's see. Yes, and I did review. I know I've reviewed some of these movies for a bad website that still, I think, exists. I don't really want to. What am I doing? What I have no beef with that site. It was imockery.com. I don't care about that website one way or the other. The guy who ran it was very nice to me. He encouraged me to do creative stuff, which I guess this sort of qualifies as. So, if it weren't for him. But he let me write movie reviews for his website, and I'm sure they were bad. They were bad reviews. I was calling his website bad because my reviews were probably pretty bad, and the reason his site was bad was probably because of me. yes. I went through YouTube and I downloaded a bunch of trailers, and hopefully they look all right. I did a little bit of trying to figure out that I was downloading the best quality version or not, but we'll see. So let's get started with that by turning up the volume. Clicking on the first one. This is a very bad looking trailer, I can tell you.
I think that's a thing about a fetish.
I'm
saying, you know, things that people find kinky, like who knows why they find it kinky.
Remember this movie?
Can I just tell this one story?
Remember this movie? This guy's famous now.
Stay up all night.
You get high and watch pornography.
If I were to write a book on religion,
the movie wasn't exactly.
It'd be called "There's No Possible Way There's a God."
Oh, that's so cool.
If his wife got hit by a car tomorrow, I'd probably start sleeping with him again.
Yeah, the movie was shot on a camcorder, basically.
Look, we just changed stuff, please.
I think my personal camera looked better than this.
Seriously, you have any sense? For the longest time, she's like hosing it down and hosing it down, like. Very suggestively, right?
Yeah, I'd like another glass of wine.
Oh, if you guys are.
If I'm with a guy and, you know, basically gets close to that.
I never got into
wine, back there,
so I think I'm really a grown up.
Basically, having orgasms instantly.
I'll never be a grown up until I start drinking wine in restaurants with other grown ups.
So I'm the only one that's just finding out right now?
Are you sure you didn't know?
How could I possibly know?
Have you decided what you'd like to order?
We never got menus.
Yeah, we're waiting to see when you figure it out.
God, you guys are killing me. I'll be right back.
Okay, I like her, but she's psycho.
Yeah. Not a very jazzy trailer. It just looks low budget. I did own this on DVD, and I remember the extras being better than the movie, because I think there was like a Fred Armisen sketch on there where he's pretending to be a guy or something. But yeah, I barely remember anything about this movie. I owned it on DVD. I know I watched it at least once. I have some vague memory of Annabelle Gurwitch, like a still of her. Like there's a flashback and they express it with stills, and she's like got her head in her hands, and I think she killed somebody by accident or something. And she's like telling this confessional story about accidentally killing somebody. All right, let's move on. I can't imagine rewatching that movie. I mean, you know, I can actually. I would watch. Not tonight. if somebody said, hey, do you want to stop doing your Twitch stream and watch Melvin Goes to Dinner, I would say no, but I would maybe do it after.
Is that guy drinking beer?
Teenage boys. What word do you think he said? Okay. I remember this scene probably from this trailer. And I'm actually not that sure if I've seen this movie, but I kind of previewed the trailer for it, and it seemed so familiar that I assume I watched this. This is a Final Destination 2. Oh, nasty! That's sick. And I worked at the theater, so I'd like watch stretches of it. I remember a guy. I don't know the difference. I probably can't really capably remember the first two. I saw the first two, and I probably wouldn't be able to tell you which scenes go for which movies. But these movies aren't that bad. I think I probably deathiscoming.com is the website. That's the URL they got for their movie.
Finally, in the news tonight, the music world mourns the death of folk music icon Irving Steinblum. Steinblum managed the careers of the Main Street Singers, the Folksmen, and Mitch and Mickey.
The only fitting tribute that we could come up with.
Respected
was
actor Bob Balaban.
I'd like to think that Mitch would agree to do this, because I already said yes.
Where else could we have such an event but Town Hall?
We're very pleased to be having the folk people here. The acoustics are just perfect.
What do you remember about this movie? I remember thinking it was okay, just okay. Store,
you knew that the new Folksman album would be one word
title:
itching, wishing, rambling, singing. But
you admire the detail that they go, they have these movies have, but it's like,
it's just that kind.
My dad, Fred Knox, was an original Main Street singer.
He's a dead person now, but when he was alive, he was so happy.
There had been abuse in my family, but it was mostly musical in
cunt
nature.
Cunt from Twitter. Are you allowed to say cunt?
I must say I
on
was
Twitch.
In awe of Mitch and Mickey. Who was it?
Mitch was mysterious.
Jane Lynch.
Intense.
Noted cunt, Jane Lynch.
Much.
We're so excited to be part of this project.
Oh, absolutely.
So,
it's a new challenge for me because I don't like folk music.
Me too.
Quick plug, Ola, I'm Mike LaFontaine.
Oh yeah, this is the part everybody remembers.
Founder of High Class Management. Whoops.
I had not a that. That's juvenile.
Hooded legged little woman.
But the what happened?
Grandma.
Those are lights.
When he says what happened?
Yes, those are lights.
Could they fall?
And that's a ceiling above us.
Excuse me, I must be full.
It's like that wire. I see a wire. I see it.
Oh, that guy's dead. All these people are dead.
I feel ready for
it's Gallagher.
A voyage on this magnificent vessel.
I love Mitch.
What if we see sailfish?
But.
Yeah, I'm just gonna pause it. Yeah, my uncle actually worked on a Christopher Guest film that shot by the Sacramento River. I'm sure everybody in this room already knows this, but I'm pretending it like this is a show that other people watch. I don't know why, but I am. I think like Tom Sharpling would talk about Christopher Guest movies in this kind of derisive way, and he kind of posited that Christopher Guest was like a really like awful misanthrope, but he like he hired my uncle as like a river guide, because that's what he did on the Sacramento River, where they were going to shoot what's that movie called? Almost Heroes. The title was I think it was called like The Real Lewis and Clark or something like that, or The Original Lewis and Clark was the original title for that movie. And they named it they wound up calling it Almost Heroes with Chris Farley and Matthew Perry. Noted rude autobiography writer Matthew Perry. Watch him die. Not quite, because that movie was shelved for, I think, like 6 years. I remember my uncle bragged about bringing a camera on the set, and he took a shitload of pictures, and he has like pictures of Chris Farley like hamming it up, and you know, like there was like a hot Native American actress. She probably wasn't Native American, but she was playing a Native American. I hope she was Native American. Just like taking pictures of them like canoodling in a kind of jokey way. Who knows if she was in on the joke, you know? I don't want to cancel a dead man, but those SNL boys, they've sure had some busy hands. He kind of befriended Christopher Guest, and I guess Christopher Guest would vacation in Northern California, and he would go out on fishing expeditions with my Uncle Hank, which blows my mind, because I think my Uncle Hank is like really hard to take. He's kind of a yahoo, but I also might have suspected that maybe Christopher Guest was just, this was like his method for gathering like character stuff or something, you know? I don't know. It really kind of made me think weirdly more of Christopher Guest when I heard that he could tolerate my uncle, but I can't. So I'm like, if Christopher Guest is a misanthrope, I'm probably a bigger one, is kind of what I take away. You wish I was a hooligan. don't reference A.O. River on here. Come on. This is for kids. I haven't watched any Christopher Guest movies in a very long time. Maybe I'll go through them. Oh, you can see the titles. I forgot to turn that off on my VLC. Not that I intended to surprise you.
Johnny English is daring. Johnny English is dashing.
I barely remember this movie.
You overestimate your power over women.
I'd say that would be virtually,
I know,
impossible.
I watched it, and I...
Johnny English is dreaming.
English!
Oh, now he's Mr. Bean.
Gentlemen.
Agent One.
God, he looks just... He's exactly Mr. Bean.
Hello.
I know it's the
this
same.
This is Intelligence Headquarters. Remember when I told you the only way you'd become
like,
an agent was if all the other agents were dead?
I liked Mr. Bean when I was younger, and
well, put some bloody clothes on and get over here right away.
I don't not like...
Thank you, sir. You're
unbelievable. I'm not like Johnny
English
on all the time.
The good agent doesn't need
Yeah, he
gadgets.
Does not have the same pizzazz as Mr. Bean.
The only gadgets
and,
Cyber needed.
Yeah,
are
no
a sharp
pizzazz.
Eye, a finely tuned ear.
And
a slightly bigger brain than is strictly necessary.
Perhaps I can.
Oh, well, none of us is perfect.
This summer, when the future of England is threatened,
get out there and save your country.
British intelligence is coming.
Maybe I should turn the video down.
I had his flat bugged.
How are these levels?
From the producers of Bean.
Yeah. I don't remember that scene. Why is he doing stuff like that? It's crazy. I remember there was like a gross joke having to do with like a corpse. That there's a scene in this trailer where like where they're like carrying a casket, and I think the carcass comes out of the casket and like. Just crass stuff. Not funny. Too rude. I don't think you should go in your furniture like that. But I saw that on vacation. That movie. Which seems pathetic. It seems pathetic to go see a feature film while you're on vacation. You will be endowed with all my powers. Yeah. I saw this in theaters. What would you do? I didn't like it that much. How would you help? How would you handle the most powerful responsibility in the universe? If I was God, I'd give everybody big old titties. Do you think he does that in this? Can you imagine if he did that? Oh no! From Universal Pictures and Spyglass Entertainment. Wow! Do you see those things? And the director of Liar Liar. Yeah, so I worked in a movie theater. At this time, and I would go on little spurts of trying to see every movie, and this was one of them. I am Bruce Almighty. It's one of those movies that I saw as an employee at the movie theater. I will note that Johnny English probably came out in like 2004 in America, but I sorted this by like earliest premiere date. That probably came out like early in the year 2003 in England, and then later in 2003, I don't know. Oh yeah. Yeah, I truly wonder what like the what the Twitch algorithm forgives. All right, Finding Nemo. Yeah, I was kind of late to the party with Pixar, because I really resented. I resented when Toy Story came out and everyone was like, "Yeah, hand drawn animation is just not going to exist anymore." And they would say it like to me because I was like a good drawer. Stay right here, swim in a little circle, forget to yourself. I'll be right back. I'm gonna ask for directions. I remember being very aware of the closing sting on this movie, because because working at the movie theater meant that I would. Excuse me. Yeah. I guess they were right. Because working in a movie theater means that you're usually, like, a lot of times you'll find yourself waiting for the movie to get over so that you can, like, pick up the trash and stuff. So, yeah, I sat through the credits of this movie and saw all the Pixar Easter eggs I didn't get. Could a bigger fish swallow me? But, yeah. Good movie. I never saw it, and I haven't seen it. I mean, I did see it. I haven't seen it since, I don't know when. I think I gave it a watch on Blu-ray. What you looking at? The old neighborhood. There are places that what is make this? Us who we are. Save! I'm guessing this is Mystic River. I missed really? Moments that the Chiron. Do not make her laugh. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, this is Mystic River. Feelings that make us question our beliefs. fears. Alright, so if I remember correctly, this movie is about a guy who does something horrible, like he strangles a girl, and maybe he does more to her. Oh yeah, he like sexually assaults that guy's daughter or something. And then,
You don't think I'd have heard her, do you?
She isn't hurt, Brendan. She's dead.
I feel like this movie had like a twist ending where the guy you think did it gets like they basically do like a, they form like a lynch mob and they kill him, and then I think you find out that he didn't do it or something. Maybe. This is such a dour fucking movie. I can't imagine like putting this on now. But I saw this in the theater and I remember liking it.
Sometimes I think all of this is just a dream, you know.
Yeah, like, I hate when movies look like this, like, all underlit and just, like, just emoting seriousness at all times.
Everyone but us. You could rule this town.
With all these people whispering about the terrible things. Run! Run! Why do men do the things they do? The thing that bothered me about this movie is that there's a part in the parade where it cuts to a little girl holding a big SpongeBob SquarePants plushie, and it's literally the only moment in the movie that feels like it's from 2003. Like, it's a very timeless feeling movie, and I just feel like they should have, I think if they were being a little more thoughtful, they might have taken that toy out and given her, like a, I don't know, like a Beanie and Cecil doll. I wonder how fat. I wonder how long I can go without peeing. Normally, it's like. Yeah.
Keep your eyes on the road, cowboy.
Don't watch this movie until you watch the short film that's on the first movie DVD as an extra, because it kind of bridges the gap.
What's his deal?
It tells you what Paul Walker's character is doing before the events of this movie. He's like robbing cars or something.
Come on, man. Guns, murderers, and crooked cops. I was made for this, bro.
I should put on commercials. These are commercials. I should just take the laptop in with the bathroom with me and show you me peeing. Too Fast, Too Furious gets a bad rap, but I remember liking it. I didn't see it in 2003. I would not have seen those movies in 2003. I would have hated the idea of them in 2003. I would have like called those like sheeple movies. And, you know... But in 2012, when I worked at a video store, I was a little more open-minded and a little more worldly. So I watched some of the... This summer, is this working? Did it stop? New Line Cinema proudly presents the greatest saga of all time. Is the video... Did the video freeze on movieclips.com for everybody? Yeah? Okay. What is the deal with that? Oh, it's because it probably, yeah, I know. Okay. All right. Let me see if I can fix that. I don't know how to do this stuff. Okay. Gameplay. Edit. I don't even know if I'm on right now. But I think I am figuring it out. Uh. See, now I wonder if this could be like a DMCA thing, or, you know, whatever that is. If it's this specific thing is somehow triggering the filter, is it going to let me? Oh, no. Let's see. Okay, that doesn't look right, does it? Okay. Yeah, that's what I just tried. I just tried to redo it. I'll redo it. This is a disaster. Jixby Phillips disaster stream. Okay. This is terrible. All right, let's try. No. Let's try something else. Let's see if it if I play a different video. See, oh shit, I think it might be the video. Okay, I think it just didn't like that video. It was the trailer for Dumb and Dumber. We just won't watch it. Okay. We're back, yeah. Did I go away during that?
Yummy.
Freeze, ladies. We got an 11350 and it ain't pretty.
You found an illegal chinchilla ranch?
You're good.
All right, so let's try to pause it on her bikini. Oh, nice. Okay. let's talk a little bit about Dumb and Dumber, which I remember we watched. Some of us watched it together. For what I believe was maybe the most one of the most convoluted movie nights we had, which was we were watching Jim Carrey movies. But they weren't really Jim Carrey movies. They were sequels to Jim Carrey movies that didn't have Jim Carrey in them. And we were watching them because Joe Biden became president. We were planning either a Trump night or a Biden night. And Biden, the way we did Biden night is that because Jim Carrey plays Biden in SNL, we watched movies that were specifically not Jim Carrey movies. So we watched Ace Ventura Jr., Son of the Mask, and Dumb and Dumber. And I think that of those three, I think Son of the Mask is the best one. It's the most insane. It looked like shit. The effects were crazy. And of course, it was a love letter to the golden age of animation, which I really love and respect. And my throat's a little dry, I'm sorry. I think Son of the Mask is worth watching. It's a beautiful work of art. And Ace Ventura Jr. Sucked. It was worthless. And Now, I did like Dumb and Dumber. Oh, wait, you're talking about the trailer. All right, okay, let's try it again. Let's see if it works. All right, there we go.
This summer,
that was a good call.
New Line Cinema proudly presents the greatest saga of all time.
Check it out. It's not what you think it's going to be.
Of Dumb and Dumber.
Sorry about that, buddy. It's my first time bringing a friend up there. You okay?
Yeah!
So high school's all about looking cool, Harry, so stick with me.
I kind of like those actors. I think they're, you know...
What stinks?
That'd be me, sir.
At the very least, they look like those guys.
Nope, it's treasure map.
Cool. And an adventure.
It's our own special bus, Harry!
Of idiotic proportions.
Freaking short bus.
The state is giving 100 grand to every school that has a special needs class.
Yeah, I did not see this movie.
Kids, we can pass off as special.
Thanks, Turk!
Bingo.
On June 13th,
I got a little surprise for you.
You got the extender?
So the premise is that they're like, they act like retards, but they're not. Arslers. I shouldn't say that word on Twitch.
Are you trying to be funny, or are you actually special?
I mean, this wasn't even, I don't even think this, like...
There was high school.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I don't even think this held up in 2003. I think in 2003, people were kind of uneasy about the premise of this.
No?
That's my boy. Girls, there's only one way to settle this. Make-out contest.
This is so sleazy.
Mom?
Hi, sweetie.
Dumb and Dumber. When Harry met Lloyd.
Did you just...
The movie takes place in the 80s, but it just feels like 2003. Cause it's so crass. Alright. And then now it's not working for Charlie's Angels. So let's watch Dumb and Dumber again. I remember there was a screening at the movie theater. There was like an employee screening where everybody got together to watch Dumb and Dumber because they were so excited. Because Dumb and Dumber is one of the funniest movies of all time, and here's the sequel. And they all had like the highest expectations for it. Like, I've never seen people more excited for a movie than all the employees of Movies 10 were for Dumb and Dumber, or the like midnight screening of it. It wasn't midnight, it was like after we closed, probably like 11:30, 11, I don't know. But I kept trying to tell people that it wasn't gonna be good, and I told them, like, you know, like, no one involved with the first one is involved with this one, and they would always go, yeah, that's because the characters are younger. And I said, no, I mean, like writers, like, it's not written by the same people, it's not directed by the same people, it's, you know, it's like there's no creative, you know, like crossover between the two. And like I had to explain that to other people who worked at a movie theater who should have sort of understooded things like that. Understooded. I just said things like that. Matt and Trey wrote this one. That's right. They did write a draft of this, didn't they? They should make that movie today.
Maybe.
Alright, can we get Charlie's Angels? Yeah, there we go. I think I unironically really like this movie. But I tend to not have much... I don't tend to have a truck for this kind of thing. A McG film. But look, there's a part where... Oh, it almost looks like they're kissing.
Yummy.
Oh, they're all so hot.
We got an 11350 and it ain't pretty.
You found an illegal chinchilla ranch?
You're good.
But I remember there's a scene in the movie where they do like burlesque. And I remember it was playing in the theater right behind the ticket booth. And so I would be like, or the ticket tearing booth. And you could hear the music. You could hear a specific music that played. And during the burlesque scene. And I remember I would always like try to be very cool about it. But I'd always go in there and watch the part where they're doing burlesque. Because it's sexy. I don't know if there's clips of it in this trailer. We might have already seen some, as a matter of fact.
This is it. You ready? Are you?
You all fine, but you crazy.
Yeah. These women are beautiful.
This is hostile, y'all.
That's the opening scene of the movie, is her doing that character.
I'll be your rescuer today.
They have 50 armed men.
I know, it hardly seems fair. We could really.
I've switched to water.
I can drive the race car.
Heidi, O'Malley.
Man, you ain't never heard of no black Irish.
Black Irish.
Who you think invented the Mac Rear? Lucky Charm, Shamrock Shake.
This is a. Yeah, this movie's pretty legit. It's a lot of fun. I'm glad that Bill Murray died before that movie was made. Okay, The Room. We gotta look at the trailer for The Room, because it is a movie from 2003. I don't think anybody in the world saw it in 2003.
A perfect world.
These are for you.
Thanks, honey. They're beautiful.
A perfect life.
I don't know when this trailer was made.
For my girl.
I wonder.
I love you, Lisa.
Some of these might be like not original theatrical trailers. Some of them might be home video trailers or something.
You can't support yourself.
I don't love him anymore. He didn't get his promotion, and he got drunk last night, and he hit me.
It's not true. I did not hit her. Well, maybe you should have a girl, Mark.
Yeah. Yeah. Maybe you're right.
I do like The Room.
I don't know yet.
We can't do this anymore.
I've seen it in the theater when they do like the call and response stuff. And I didn't really love that much, but it was still fun to be in that room, I guess.
You're having an affair with Lisa, aren't you?
I need more from life than what Johnny can give me.
She's a sociopath. She can't love anyone.
There is no baby. I told him that to make it interesting.
There's like clips of this in a Tim and Eric episode, and I remember being like, that's real.
I treat you like a princess.
No way. I wasn't that young.
You are tearing me apart, Lisa!
I make my 2008 self sound like I was like 13. I was like,
shut up.
I was like 30. I was 30. Was I?
The Room. A film with the passion of Tennessee Williams.
No.
Directed by Tommy Wiseau. The best movie of the year.
Thank God. That would have ruined my night if I was 30 in 2007. Comedy.
It's a riot.
Yeah, there's Tommy. He's reclaiming the film as a comedy because everyone laughed at it. It's, we all know the story.
You don't know what this is, do you?
This is another one that I saw
gold.
In the name of the seeing every movie in the theater, the gold, which I never really accomplished. I would have little spurts of being like, I'm going to try to get into the habit of seeing every movie every week. And then I would just kind of...
They've taken Elizabeth.
Welcome aboard.
So I'd see all of them really quickly.
We must save her.
Where do we start?
And then another one would come out, like a new one.
Make a deal with him. He could lead us to it.
You forget your place.
Like, I'd see 9 movies in 1 week, and then, like, on Friday, there'd be 3 new movies, and I'd be like, I don't have to rush. And then I just never saw them.
You're a pirate.
Yeah, this is the first one. Stars Johnny Depp as pirate.
You're not facing normal pirates. Cruel, demented, vicious pirates, to be certain.
Say goodbye! Good boy.
Boss, cruel, demented, vicious pirates who cannot be killed. The moonlight shows us for what we really are.
I saw this and the second one.
We are cursed.
And I remember this one being like, it was better than I thought it would be. Because I had just like extremely low expectations. And then,
Jets, you all remember Captain Jack Sparrow.
That rules. Sleeping on purpose rules. It's a good idea to do. It's a good protest. I remember I pretended like I didn't want to see graphic violence because I didn't want to watch Saving Private Ryan.
Here they come.
I saw the second one in theaters because I went with friends, and
Pirates,
man,
of the Caribbean, the curse.
That second one is
Pearl.
Maybe one of the worst movies I've ever seen in a theater. But it's gotta look good on DVD.
The life you know.
Remember this movie?
All the stuff you take for granted.
Isn't it weird that this is no longer the worst Terminator movie?
Imagine a world of permanent darkness.
Girl power.
Machines control man's destiny. Imagine you were the only one who could stop it. But before you do, something terrible.
There she is, Claire Danes. You know what's terrible is every time I see Claire Danes, I think of the a snippet of the Syphil and Ollie song about Claire Danes. Like Liam Lynch going, Claire Danes! Always pops into my head when I see her.
John Connor was here. Where is he?
And I saw her last in Grigsby Bear. Starring Kyle Mooney.
She's coming.
A little nervous fella from Saturday Night Live.
TX has corrupted my system.
The machines, they're starting to take over.
I remember I had a magazine with, like this. Oh yeah, that's a. I love that image of him with the fucking casket over his shoulder, shooting robots with a machine gun. I had a magazine with that image on the cover. This magazine that used to come to the theater that was just for like, it was like just a trade magazine, but it had these really great, kind of glossy photos of movies. So I'd always nab them. Chris Hardwick is in this movie. He like turns on the machine that starts everything. Like he used to go on stage and brag about it, be like, "I'm the guy that started the boop, boop, boop. What's that called? Judgment Day." I don't know. I've only seen each of those movies once. I was too scared of it when I was like a kid. And it was like every kid's first R-rated movie. The dope runners have gone low. The biggest shipment on record is coming in tonight. What is this again? They got a lot of firepower and they hate the law. Oh. Man.
Oopsie daisy. It's the Negress.
He can say it.
I had an epiphany. I realized that God sent you here to test me.
I saw this movie.
And who be you?
Me? I shot you.
It's like it hit the meat.
In theaters, and it was like 2.5 hours. I think he said, I think he pronounced the word Negroes, is what he actually said.
Don't hate the player, hate the game.
Hate the teller.
But, Yeah, I remember leaving after 2 hours. There was like a still 40 minutes of it left. And this was one of the most interminable movies I've ever seen in a movie theater. I know I said that for I forget what, but there are several movies this year that I feel like were progressively like a new low for me. And I honestly think of 2003 as maybe being one of the worst movie years to ever that for me to ever like live through. Like there's a scene where there's like some scene where he goes into a Best Buy and it's like this comedy scene where he accidentally like sounds gay and there's like a camcorder set up that's filming him and it goes on all the TVs and like this weird like cartoonish portrayal of like service workers and stuff, you know? Those are essential workers.
Their powers are legendary.
The McDonald's Playface Jail. I wish that guy were still around. Are unknown. The outsider we're talking about. I know literally no one else is going to watch this, but I just like to... It's like to pretend that this is being played on the Jumbotron in Times Square. I remember nothing about this movie. I know I saw it. It's Sean Connery's final film. It was an adaptation by Alan Moore. I have Alan Moore books. Told you I had spooky stuff in here. And then this one, I didn't see this because I worked at the theater. I saw this, and this is another one where I was on vacation. Attention. The new spy I thought it was League of Gentlemen. Yeah. Comedy Central, all new shows. Remember? That was like...
Coming soon to DVD.
They did this like bouncy thing like for the summer.
Your sister's missing.
And then, like, part of the clip package was League of Gentlemen, which is, like, literally the least summery show that's ever been produced.
Well, not if we can help it. The game is a trap.
The third mission.
There's a trap.
On these glasses, and you'll enter the world of the game.
There he is.
You go in, find your sister, help her shut
down
the game.
Fuck yeah, dude. Fucking Mike Judge, dude.
The third dimension.
I'm looking for my sister. She's somewhere on level 4.
I saw this in the theater in 3D, and it was the Anaglyph 3D. It was not the polarized 3D, which is better because it doesn't make the colors look all fucked up. And I've never seen any of the other Spy Kids movies, so this movie seemed like extra insane to me because there's like a part where they're like referencing all this, like these characters come back from the other movies. And, like, they introduced them in this very, like, theatrical way, like you already know who they are, and it was just really delightful. Who's that actress?
Mega Race.
Not the kid, the,
dangerous race in the game world.
Redhead adult.
You get the glasses.
I'm assuming that's this time.
You're part of the
See, this is not theatrical trailer. Did they change the scene? Fuck. So the actual theatrical trailer has that exact same scene, but it's set in a theater. And that always delighted me. Like, the idea of seeing a movie... You go to see a movie, and then the character just starts punching at you for no reason.
Going according to plan this year.
Looks like a fine schedule to me, Hallie.
I'm signed up for boys. P.E. Why don't you just...
I saw this movie.
Anything, okay?
In my last year of high school,
not in a bid to see every movie,
my sister got engaged,
but because I genuinely had a very big crush on Mandy Moore.
She's high.
Mother, are you smoking?
I had a little headache, but I'm feeling better.
And I remember liking this movie.
My
it's very, you know,
lost her mind, among other things.
It's kind of childish,
like
but it's fun.
Mush over something like
sex?
Yeah.
My parents. Like, I can picture like a 13-year-old girl seeing this in the theater and thinking that she, you know, feeling very grown up.
Toss, please. Now.
Watching like a
and
grown
then the
up.
The worst
movie.
Thing of all happened.
Hi, Allie.
Because like
I met him.
It's like someone dies
when
in it or something.
When I ask you to go out with me this Friday night, you're gonna think you're the one asking me.
And you don't want to go out on a date with me?
I told you you'd ask me. You're gonna kiss me, Allie.
That sounds like a lot of people on iMockery. I took home a giant Subway ad and a giant like tarp lobby ad for this movie from the theater, and a one sheet, and I hung them all up in my room to make stupid photos, to take stupid pictures of me for that website.
The more you live, people are flawed, people screw up.
Yeah, because I'm sheeple for liking a pop star. The more you learn, she seems nice.
Give me a hug.
With family, she seems like a nice, cool person.
With friends.
Maybe
can you blame me?
Strips didn't look completely pink. They were just kind of pinkish.
Five kids, Hallie.
I remember the actor. Jump, that actor, the boy. The pretty boy.
Mandy Moore, Allison Janney, Peter Gallagher.
Peter Gallagher.
Trent Ford.
No, Trent Ford. I remember he went on the new Tom Green show, and he showed a video of him riding the public bus, because he was bragging about how he'd ride the public bus. And he's also British. And you can tell by looking at him, but I remember, you know, he's British. He confirmed it with his voice and his accent and stuff.
In 2300 BC, uh-oh. Egyptian pharaoh found a place that he named.
Something happened with the video. That didn't fix it. That didn't fix it. That didn't fix it. I think we lost the video.
In 2300 BC, an Egyptian pharaoh found a place that he.
All right, give me a minute. That might have done it. All right. Tomb Raider 2.
300 BC, an Egyptian pharaoh found a place that he named the Cradle of Life.
I just got your John Wilson joke. Thank you. Took me a while.
And death. And it has never been seen since.
His name is Jonathan Rice, and he doesn't care who his weapons kill or why.
Rice is going to find Pandora.
I remember I found this movie to be just tremendously boring, but it was cheap. Shorter than Bad Boys 2, so I wound up sitting through the whole thing.
I need it inside of someone who knows their methods, their hideouts. I need Terry Sheridan.
I never really appreciated
no weapons of any kind.
Angelina Jolie. Talk about taking the fun out of that much. She's a beautiful woman. Don't get me wrong. But I never really got it.
So this rock is the map to Pandora's box.
Lara! It's in Africa.
Africa it is.
Men are coming for the box.
No one will
come back. No. I got a little high before this, folks. Oh, it's this song. This cool song. It plays during only cool stuff. What is this freaking barbarian now? Because it has a guy like that in there. Remember? You don't remember? Nice. So I might own that, because I actually have a lot of HD DVDs. Oh, I have like 20. There we go, and it's... This is not like my playlist. Okay, there we go. Alright, so this movie, unfortunately for me... I'd long dined out on the fact that I observed something very smart, which was that both this movie and the trailer for Radio, not only is there similar dialogue in the trailer, but they also both used the same music.
Fred Pollard, Mr. and Mrs. Howard.
But I watched this before tonight.
Of course it's nuts.
This trailer. Well, and it doesn't use that music that I thought it did. For something. You don't throw a, and I'll point it out when we get to Radio. It's the music. It's a horse again. The theme song from
Charlie Stop.
Dragon, the Bruce Lee story. And it has lived a second life as a often used trailer song. It's one of the most cliched trailer songs. Trailer music.
Well, I just think this horse has a lot of heart.
I'll lay even money that this nag Sea Biscuit couldn't even finish 6 furlongs.
I told you, look out for
it's got,
Rosemont.
Yeah, it's got Bill Macy. See, this song sounds... Yeah, this music sounds very similar to it. That song. But there's actually... There is a chance that they rescored this trailer. Because that does happen. That's not Jurassic Park. Jurassic Park is Jurassic Park. Jurassic Park. Did I do Jurassic Park? It's like... That's the Bruce Lee story song. Did I do it right this time?
Don't stop, boy. Don't ever stop.
Because I believe you. I believe you that I did it wrong in the first time. I believe you. I believe women. I didn't like that. I didn't like Seabiscuit.
Michelle Annabeth Flaherty.
Yeah, whatever that Seabiscuit song was.
More than I could ever explain.
And Jurassic Park.
Will you marry me?
And the Bruce Lee story. Those are three, like, that's a real three-headed hybrid, where you know that you're about to see some fucking cinema.
She was getting married.
Do you have the slightest idea of how important this is?
We get to have a bachelor party.
This is awesome!
I remember this movie. Welcome. I've seen this film.
Jim! Michelle's parents are here.
Oh, Jim, look what you did.
I remember thinking that Stifler was extra buffoonish in this film. Like, he was like a he wasn't very edgy. He was just like a cartoon.
We've got it together, baby.
There's pubes in the trailer. Ugh.
Boy, hair was just not an issue when I was dating.
I keep messing up.
Is this
up.
The song? Are they gonna use James?
Keep happening to me. I promised you the wedding of your dreams, and I'm not gonna let anything use it again.
It's time for me to boom boom with the bridesmaids.
This bed is on fire with passion.
You're cordially invited.
I'll meet you at the closet.
To the event. And it's like extreme. It's so like these movies really aren't anything special. But...
Stifler?
Granny.
What?
Focus!
There's something when you hear that song set to clips. It kind of tricks you into thinking that you love these movies. As American Pie. That song does a lot of heavy lifting.
Animal lush thing. It's deeper than that.
American Wedding.
The longer a marriage lasts, the longer you can go.
I think Bringing Down the House was 2003. Okay, I did not see. I don't think I saw that motion picture. I may have missed movies.
Are you?
Oh
wow. I went through IMDb and tried to pick out. I found like several movies that I hadn't rated on IMDb, which is how I determine whether I've seen it or not. This is G. Lee. Which, if you don't remember, was considered kind of like the bomb of the year, like the bad movie of the year, like the punchline bad film of that year. Stars Ben Affleck. There's a bull and a cow. I'm the bull. You're the cow. Got that? Yeah, people would quote that.
What?
Oh, come on, Larry.
Oh yeah, it's got a neurodivergent guy in it. A lot of cutesy.
That's good.
Yeah. If
you
want to, relationship humor with the mental, the spastic in the family. This may be a good time to suggest that you not allow this hope to sprout in your soul. How could Kevin Smith do this? I remember thinking that it was like a conspiracy against Kevin Smith because they rushed this into theaters before Jersey Girl. This was shot after they became an item, but it came out before. And I remember thinking that was like some sort of thing they were doing to Kevin Smith because he was my favorite director. Not really. I don't think he was at that point, but this movie's bad. There's a part where the retarded guy sings. I like big butts and I cannot lie. That's like a big, supposed to be like hilarious scene in the movie.
We should take a nap.
I think we're good together. Ben
Affleck, Jennifer Lopez. Every relationship has a flaw in a cow, huh?
Choice. Yeah. This was directed by Martin Brest. Charmin Ultra Double Roll. Yeah, he directed like 5 movies. I'm gonna pause this. He directed like he made Meet Joe Black, which was successful, but it was kind of a punchline too, I think, right? Because it was really long and weird. But he made, what did he make? He made Beverly Hills Cop. He made he directed a Midnight Run and Scent of a Woman. So he'd like, there was like a while there where he'd like make a movie like every 5 years and they would always be like a monster hit, and then he made Geely and then he'd like disappeared and didn't direct another movie again. Because I think he was just embarrassed. Hang on. So I do need to pee. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to just replay this. Beneath a rugged exterior,
Larry Sheely was a nice guy. Are you?
You know me, I'm going to be fine. Putting on a good show. That's professional. He's
just been given his big break. It might be a long pee, so I'm going to slow it down. Okay, I'll be right back. I should probably mute the microphone because I don't know if it's gonna pick up my pee.
His kid. An even bigger surprise.
Hello. I'm sorry.
Do we know each other?
Not yet.
I guess Lewis would feel more comfortable if there were 2 independent contractors working on this.
I want you to work with her, and I want you to watch her as she will be watching you.
Let me tell you something.
relationship, there's a bull and a cow. I'm the bull. You're the cow. Got that?
Yeah, I got it. Bull cow.
Reach me, Larry.
What?
Oh, come on, Larry. Read to him.
I got nothing here.
You don't have a book.
For well over a century, the adventurous flavor of Tabasco sauce has fired up generations of thrill seekers. Okay?
This is good.
If you want to, you can, you know, take half of my bed.
That's very kind of you. I'd love to.
Do the whole thing professionally.
Yeah, no.
This may be a good time to suggest that you not allow the seeds of cruel hope to sprout in your soul.
I don't know what that means, but it sounds beautiful.
It means you're not my type.
All right.
Good night.
Good night.
I hope you liked watching this in slow motion.
She thinks I'm beautiful.
Yeah, she's blind to one eye.
Alright. Bad movie. And we gotta get it back. Now this one, this could be DMCA'd. Because it's owned by a very powerful, very extravagant company, very exclusive, very rich company. Here we go.
Honey, wake up.
Let's all be careful what we say.
Hurry up! What? I'm ready.
For the Coleman family, Mondays are manic.
Bye, honey. Make good choices.
Wednesdays are wild.
Yeah, my room!
And for Anna and
hear the
Chris,
song?
There's never enough time.
It's the ultimate.
Understand each other.
By Lindsay Lohan.
What?
Plays at the end of the movie.
Perfect. You couldn't last one day in my high school.
Okay.
That's all about to change. Because things are going to get a little freaky.
Why am I in Anna's room?
This isn't mine. Those aren't mine.
That's definitely not mine.
Walt Disney Pictures presents.
So you're in my body and I'm in your body.
I remember legitimately liking this movie.
I beg your pardon.
Oh, I'm like the Crypt Keeper!
Friday.
That was very funny. Imagine walking in on your mom and your sister scissoring. And yeah, the playlist is there we go. Now, does anybody remember this movie at all? And it's ignore the Casper. This is not officially sanctioned by the people at Calendar Girls Entertainment.
Anyone fancy some chips?
Oh, yeah.
That joke right there, that's the end of the movie. That's the movie ends on that joke.
Always did its part for charity.
This year's fundraising calendar.
Where they're doing like fitness and then they go, let's go eat some chips, which if you didn't know, in England means
Annie and Chris.
What is it?
Baby dicks.
Charity is closer to home.
I'd like to read something that Annie's husband John wrote. The flowers of Yorkshire.
Is this ex- like is this is this literally the
last stage of their growth is the most glorious.
And the only
driving
way to
Miss
raise
Daisy
more money
music?
Than
no.
ever before is to go further than anyone ever imagined.
It's like a sound
we're planning
alike, right?
A calendar for John
and proposing on it.
And that's about it, really.
Naked. It's what John suggested.
This
I
is
use the phrase whip your bras off.
Now, yeah.
They've got fears.
We don't do.
I remember not hating
we're not
it.
We're going to go around parading ourselves in a room full of men.
This was definitely me France? Trying to see
they've
every
got issues.
My mom's being weird.
Women this go through movie. A difficult age.
How do you know?
My dad told me.
And they've got to decide just how far they're willing to go.
They'll never go through with it.
You're looking at January.
February.
March.
What is going on?
Inspired by the remarkable true story.
The other thing I remember is that Patton Oswalt is in it. In a very minor role.
The person is naked. Touchstone Home
he's like,
presents a group of ordinary women.
I'm 55. If I'm not gonna
he's
go
like
to
a limo driver who goes, hey, you're those girls. You're those girls who got
I
naked. Can I get an autograph?
John, and I'm prepared to take my clothes off for a calendar.
Helen Mirren, Julie Walters.
T-minus 2 hours. Bras off to avoid strut marks. We're going to need considerably bigger buns.
Calendar girls.
Thanks for watching. Oh yeah, I have to remember to shout out the I don't think I got any FT depots in here, but yeah, the it freezes every time. The playlist was working at first, but now it's it makes me go back and forth. There we go. Oh, it's because the aspect ratio changes, I bet. Remember thinking like, oh fuck, what is this gonna fucking be, dude? Fuck yeah! Holy shit! You know what should be in the next one is Ash!
We're not safe awake or asleep.
I remember I saw this in the theater and I ran into a friend of mine, like, and he was actually a pretty good friend of mine. Like, he was one of my main friends. And, he was there alone, and I was also there alone, and we went up sitting, he was like, I didn't know you liked this kind of stuff, and I was like, yeah, sorta. He was like, we should have been, like, hanging out, watching horror movies and stuff.
21. I don't care, they're all the same shape.
Like, somehow it just never came up that we both kind of had an affinity for horror movies. Okay, this is another one where I just was trying to see every movie.
Could you even imagine what it must be like to ride in that thing?
There were teenagers in the theater with me.
What does that mean?
And they were smoking weed. There was Lindsay Felton.
Get the moron out of the pool.
They were smoking weed and they came over and they offered me some. And I wasn't cool enough to smoke weed, so I said no. And I said, but go ahead, you guys can smoke weed. I won't narc out because I'm a little bit cool. And they believed it. They agreed with me that I'm a little bit cool. I heard them all saying, that guy's cool over there, maybe, a little bit, sort of. Bam Margera plays himself in this, and he plays like a heel turn cad. He's like a cad. he's like a villain.
It's time to be discovered.
He's not like the villain, but he's like mean to the heroes. And they go like, oh man, I guess success is went to Bam Margera's head.
Awesome.
What a lesson to learn about show business. And I think it's like really telling that Bam Margera just didn't think about that whatsoever, that he was in a movie playing a jerk. Because he probably just is a jerk. And he read that screenplay and says like, yeah, that's... I would be mean to these normal guys coming up to me. There's a scene in this movie with Lindsay Felton. There she is. Oh, fuck. Okay. It's like the opposite of a jump scare. Because it's literally the hottest a girl has ever looked in the history of the world. And I wish there was more of her in the trailer. And again, I know the video. The video.
For Marcy Feld, life was all about
jump boner. Yes, it was.
Is about to end.
Controversy is erupting over the new CD by gangster rap star Dr. S.
This recording is unspeakably offensive.
Okay.
I blame the man who profits from these albums.
Yes.
Do I really own this label?
I blame Ben Feld. Daddy?
If you have any more stress, it could kill you. I need 10 cc's of Valium right now.
So that guy, I didn't even... He's the director of the film? Richard Benjamin? And I didn't know that he was like an actor, and I thought he was an amateur actor, like a director putting himself in his own movie.
I love my father, and I can't even help him.
She's never gone before.
Get out there.
This movie is a huge piece of shit. One of the most remarkably unfunny comedies I've ever seen in my life. It was written by the guy who wrote In and Out. And Adam's Family Values, which I love that movie, but I remember after seeing this movie, it made me want to reevaluate my love for Adam's Family Values, because this is such a bad movie.
Children with no feeling in their arms.
This is whack.
That means bad.
Get out of your element, babe, because you're not real.
If I can get real, will you sincerely apologize?
What you gonna do? You gonna rap for us?
Marseille. Hi, hi. I'm so real.
I'll
tell you how I feel. I'm just not very musical. Although I did love Lion King.
So she raps in the movie.
Who you are.
You have insulted my people.
And the end of the movie, the closing credits is her rapping. And I remember it was just made me feel miserable. I didn't want to, like, I felt legitimately embarrassed to be sitting there in the theater watching it. And I, like, couldn't leave during it. Because I was afraid of, like, drawing attention to myself leaving the theater while Marcy X rapping is playing behind me. Like, coming out of the theater. I thought it would ruin me.
For Marcy Feld, life was. Tom Stansfield had one eye on promotion.
Something wrong with the coffee? It's a little bitter.
Audrey, get in here!
Sir, really?
Audrey,
I'm gonna have to let you go.
And the other eye.
This is a bad movie,
daughter.
Too.
Do you have any plans to
this was produced by a Zucker.
My dad's house by six?
Sure. I think it might have been directed by a Zucker, actually. This is a David Zucker film.
Feel good? I feel like I'm gonna throw up.
Well, that's good. I want you to use that, okay?
He got a big surprise.
How could he be so excited about house sitting?
He's nice, Daddy.
Oh, sir.
This movie was originally called something else, like The House Guests or something.
OJ, like the murderer?
No.
And then Ashton Kutcher became considerably more famous, and they re-edited the movie to make him be like the main character, I think. He was originally more ensemble.
Hey,
hanging around.
Pizza's here.
Andy Richter. It's very like Fairly Brothers derivative. This movie. That's a legitimately very funny joke.
Lisa, I was just checking these girls for breast cancer.
You'll have to keep the house from falling apart.
No, not David Koechner. There's a scene in the movie. There's another scene. There's, the end of the movie is them all singing, If I Had a Million Dollars, I'd Buy You a Monkey by the Bare Naked Ladies. Hey, Jeffrey Tambor.
You and I never are gonna work, and that hurts. But not as much as watching you be controlled by a ruthless tyrant that would sell his own mother if he thought it'd help him get ahead.
Tom!
He's behind me, isn't he? Behavior? It did it. Okay.
For relaxing times, make it Suntory time.
I have not watched this in a very long time, and I remember like loving it to an embarrassing degree.
With the intensity.
Is that everything? It seemed like he said more than that.
It also doesn't make me feel great knowing that Scarlett Johansson was under 18.
Yes, I should be doing movies. Yeah.
You know Lat Pack?
Rat Pack?
A ring a ding ding.
Mr. Harris, Mr. Kazo sent me my stockings.
I don't know, the music is kind of giving me the feels a little bit.
Lift them? What?
That's, you know.
What are you doing?
But I can't, you can't ignore that photo of,
I wasn't doing anything, so I came along.
What do you do?
The picture of Bill Murray with his hand around Scarlett, and he's clearly copying a feel. You know that picture?
The good news is the whiskey works.
I remember in 2003 people passing that around and being like, you know what, that guy's still great. He's still such a great guy.
I'm in.
I've been waiting for him to get canceled, because it is kind of like, it's legitimately shitty that he knocked his wife around and stuff like that. I mean, I'm never not going to, like, not enjoy his movies.
The more you know who you are and what you want.
And I feel like he's weirdly tried to atone for that stuff, but
you really are having a midlife crisis, huh?
He just can't not be him. He can't not be a hothead with eight brothers. Aww. They're in love. I'm not affiliated with the Coolidge Corner Theater, by the way. They just had the best upload of this trailer for some reason. I remember liking this movie, too.
Would you like to tell me what's been bothering you?
No, I don't like being outdoors.
Tell me you've left the house in 3 days.
One, two, three.
Have you eaten anything?
Isn't this the basis
days?
Of the water Besides slide episode of...
Anything else?
It's always fun. It's always funny.
These distractions...
It's always funny.
What would you do if you had to change careers?
In Philadelphia.
What, if I wasn't an antiques broker?
If you weren't a criminal.
This is Dr. Klein. I just got off the phone with Angela, your daughter.
Dude, Con, I remember I had this idea to open up like a porn theater, but it only plays stuff like Wild Things.
I have a daughter.
I'm an idiot.
Now you have to set an example for someone else.
Beer.
Cheers.
Just try to be as honest and open with them as possible.
Right.
You're a con man?
Con artist.
And that guy, Frank?
He's my partner.
Teach me something.
Rule number one, never work near where you live.
Don't.
Rule number two, don't write anything down.
You regret it, exposing her to that?
Well, you know, it was a little, it made me feel a little, you know, I really liked it. How much do you think we can take that guy for?
That's
30 grand. More.
Come on,
this 14-year-old girl working these people with me.
Smooth operator.
I'm not very good at being a dad. I barely get by being me.
You good to go?
Is a po-po in the woods?
Just say yes, okay? There's one last thing.
Yeah.
I want you to give the money back.
This is so...
She was gonna say gay.
No, it does. It does, just not very well.
You could tell she was about to say gay.
With the rent by the end of the week, he's out of here.
You wake me up for that?
Sarah Silverman pigeonholed yet again, playing the bitchy girlfriend. Roll, but nobody was
buying. You're an embarrassment.
But for Richard Linklater,
maybe it's time to give up those dreams.
Don't you miss rocking out? You're not a teacher, Ned. You're the cross-dressing incubus from Maggot Death.
Dewey, I'm not a satanic sex god anymore. I'm a sub, and soon I'll be a certified teacher.
So when I worked at the theater, I would watch large stretches of this movie during the day, and I loved it.
Hello, this is Ned Schnabley.
So I would. I love just watching random sections of it so much.
Doesn't that mean you're drunk?
And then I went and saw the movie, and it was a letdown. Obviously, probably because I had already seen the entire movie pieced together. But I don't know. I really liked the idea that this movie was just happening. Like, every single scene takes place in a class, in this classroom almost. So you just go in and watch it, and it would just seem like there was a class happening in that theater all day, and you just go in and watch it, and it was just, I don't know, there was something so charming about that.
My dad won't let me.
It was like a level of immersion that was never intended.
No allowance, chores, bullies.
All you bullies get out of my way, cause I am really ticked off!
Led Zeppelin let them use a song.
That was a really cool lesson today.
Oh, thanks, dude.
All they wanted was an education.
They're gonna laugh at me.
You have an incredible...
That's the montage where they're playing Bonzo Goes to Bitburg, probably, right? A revolution. I've just been informed. That's probably my favorite part of the movie. It's so schmaltzy, but...
Jack Black. The School of Rock.
It will Hell test yeah. your head and your mind and your brain.
Okay, so this is actually a fan recreation, an HD recreation of the teaser trailer for Kill Bill. So no, some of the shots are actually not the shots that are used in the trailer, but it was the best that they had available.
Action.
Yes, London, I remember that, the Jimmy Page thing. This is like a trailer for both parts, which we didn't know at the time, I believe, right? We didn't know that this was going to get split up yet, I think. Kill Bill Volume 1 might be my favorite Quentin Tarantino movie, and Kill Bill Volume 2 might be my least favorite Quentin Tarantino movie. I watched a lot of this. I saw it opening day. I went to the first showing. I couldn't wait. I think I worked that night, so I saw it in the afternoon and then clocked in.
You didn't think it was going to be that easy, did you?
Kill Bill Volume 1, I mean. And I loved it so much, and I would just watch long stretches of it at work. I would watch, I would go back and sit through it. And yeah, I think it still holds up. I watched that fan edit that kind of puts it all together into one thing. New Line Cinema presents the story. It like resembles the Quentin Tarantino whole Bloody Affair cut. But I know I can't help but not think of that stupid fucking Robot Chicken sketch. Buddy's experiencing a world he never knew. I forgot that James Caan was in this. He's certifiably insane. That's him, right? Discovering what it takes to fit in and going where no elf has gone before. What he needs is to be nurtured. Bring him home. Introduce him to. I remember liking this movie. I've only seen it once, I think. How long do you think you'll be with us?
I was thinking like forever.
He cannot stay here. I feel like a lot of people first like got their crush on Zooey Deschanel from this movie. We can take him. I remembered Zooey Deschanel from the this holiday season. She played the sister in
my tongue swells up when I am around you.
Get ready.
Plan out our whole day. I thought maybe we could make gingerbread houses and maybe even hold hands.
The fuck is that movie called? That Cameron Crowe movie. Get the star on top. Of elfish proportions. Almost Famous. Will Ferrell. Okay, people, I remember Almost Famous. She played the sister in that. And I remember thinking that she was insanely pretty.
I didn't know you had elves here.
You're hilarious, my friend.
Did you have to borrow a reindeer to get down here?
Hey,
you're feeling strong, my friend. Call me Elf one more time.
It's a very funny scene.
He's an angry elf. Look at you.
He thinks he's getting a hug. No way.
Hey, Elf, what's your favorite color?
You wish. Now this movie, I didn't see this till recently, thanks to one of our movie nights. Wondered if there is intelligent life elsewhere in the
universe. Whoa! What was that?
Sound like a sonic boom.
Now this movie was so boring. To begin
our training. Testing.
It wasn't lowbrow enough.
Sit. Speak.
This fall. Take me to your leaders.
Leaders?
The dogs who walk you?
The secret of.
Oh, yeah, he looks like Joel Hodgson.
People are in charge. Will be unleashed. You don't see us picking up that poop.
It's the origin of Mystery Science Theater. He stages it with dogs. The end credits is set to footage of dogs playing in sprinklers. And I remember people would sit and watch that. Like, a lot of people would stay and watch the dogs playing in the sprinklers. And I remember hearing, like, audiences howling with laughter at the footage of the dogs, like, biting the sprinklers and stuff. Broderick was pretty flat. So is Chevy Chase and Karate Dog. I think people like, yeah, sure, I'll voice a dog. That'll be fun. And then they like get to the studio and they're like, oh no. Fuck. I'm voicing a dog. God damn it. I can't get out of this now. So they just read their lines glumly.
I just saw something.
That's it. If somebody's out there, just come on out!
What is that? The hitchhiker. What were they all doing here?
This is a bad movie.
What the hell are you doing in my house?
You're all gonna die.
And it's more, but it's more memorable than the prequel that came out after this. Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the beginning. Which was the first film print that I ever built up as a projectionist was the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the beginning. And then I had to, as part of my job, sit and watch the movie. Literally getting paid to watch a movie. Because I had to make sure that all the splices were correct and all that stuff, and I didn't, like, fuck something up. And yet I still wanted my money back. That's embarrassing, because I literally remembered saying that joke a lot. Telling people, I built up the print for Texas Chainsaw Massacre in the beginning, and then I had to watch it, so I literally got paid to watch a movie. But I still wanted my money back. Ladies, I'm better than a movie. I think I'm better than cinema.
Small things become big. One thing.
The aspect ratio doesn't look right on this one, but you know, what are you gonna do? All right, we're close to the end.
I'm not a bear.
Well, gee, you're one big beaver.
This came out. I'm a man. I don't know. Probably November.
Are you okay?
I was transformed into a bear. Magically.
But crazy!
Because then I...
This November, Walt Disney Pictures proudly presents...
This movie has a scene... That's not in the movie. That's fake. This movie has a scene where...
Try not to scare off the fish there, buddy.
Yeah! My name's Coda. Say it with me. Coda.
There's a scene in the movie where... the aspect ratio changes. Like, the scene gets wider. And it's after, so it's about a human who gets turned into a bear, and when he's a human, the movie's in 4:3 in the theaters, and then when he opens his eyes for the first time as a bear, the movie's in widescreen. And I remember being at Costco, and some mom came up to me, because she could tell that I was like a DVD expert.
Oh, really?
And she said, excuse me, which one's full screen and which one's widescreen? I want to get the right kind. Which is the one where it's where it doesn't have the bars? And she's holding a copy of Brother Bear. So now I have like a specific
Disney Pictures Brother Bear.
I can not only like normally I wouldn't try to sell like strangers on widescreen, but I had like specific knowledge about this movie benefiting from widescreen, and so I couldn't help myself. And she was just like, so this one has the bars? And I was like, yeah, that one has the bars. And she goes, okay, thanks. And then she put it down and walked away with the full screen.
If you watch it.
Made an ass of myself at the Costco.
Oh, man.
What?
It'll be 1 week from today.
You heard about this videotape? The one where they do it on the boat? And then in the car?
I just saw this. I saw The Ring for the first time.
Not that tape.
Three times the terror.
I mean, like, Jenny McCarthy is pretty hot, right? And she's, like, charming in a way.
Call it women's intuition or ESPN or both, but I can tell when danger's near. I just...
Hey, it's a Dick Dietrich.
Take over human bodies.
To be any one of these people, move slowly toward the exit.
You can't do stuff like that.
Yo, what do we think? I don't know what I'm doing here. This is totally pathetic.
No, you can't shoot Simon. Ah, even if you wanna.
Where is my daughter?
Are you mad? I am your
daughter. No. Ooh.
What did you do with Sue?
I didn't touch her, I swear.
I don't believe it.
Freaking Wacko Jacko.
She's a girl.
Scary Movie 3.
The killer videotape.
That's right, he is gay.
Let's roll it again.
Oh no. Yeah, I saw that movie. I hated Scary Movie 2 because it was done by non-whites. So I saw Scary Movie 3 to, you know, right the ship.
We do
to white the ship.
Full speed.
I don't mean
in
that.
Town, driven by competition.
I'm Coach being an irony, bro.
Boys gonna take us back to state.
If I was to tell you that, you wouldn't have anything to talk about.
The last thing anyone wanted.
This is the radio trailer.
You just make room for your daughter and football.
Was a distraction.
Hey, Einstein, throw it over here. Come on, throw it.
There we go.
Hey, Coach,
this is the radio trailer. And there's a scene in, there's a line in the Seabiscuit trailer where they say something like, we thought we were the ones learning about, we thought we were the ones teaching Seabiscuit. Turns out Seabiscuit was teaching us. And then that line appears in this trailer. It's not about Seabiscuit, it's about radio. So like the Hollywood, you know, neuroatypical podcasters, like radio, are the same as, you know, horses.
Just wonder if you run a football program or a social club.
It just seems so cartoonish that they would be against the idea of, like, special ed. Radio, come on. Oh, this is the song. This is the song.
I figure it's the right thing to do.
Gary Powers has released from the Soviet Union. True or false?
False!
What'd you say, radio?
False!
I know we haven't had much chance to talk.
Radio needs what you're doing more than I do.
You play with heart and never stop believing in each other.
It's just better if we...
This is the way we from the Bruce Lee story,
you take
this music.
Out of this school, you might as well just take his life from it.
I'm so sure we're trying to help somebody here.
Never a mistake to care for someone.
But truth is, we're not the ones been teaching radio. Radio's the one been teaching us.
There it is. Khan, thank you for saying that. This is honestly kind of why I want to do this type of shit.
Hi, Mrs. Kwan.
Hanging out with people who are like, ooh, I'll watch that.
I'll be back in a couple of hours. Conrad, Sally, remember the rules. No playing ball.
So a lot of us saw this one recently. I did not see it at the time. There's no way I would see this.
Put in the living room or else.
Took a few years to like get any kind of ironic value from this movie.
This holiday season,
this just looked too much of a bummer at the time.
DreamWorks Pictures and Imagine Entertainment invite you to the ultimate house party.
Let's get this party started.
No. Especially, is thing one and thing two in the trailer? Because oh god, I hate them. I hate them so much.
Mike Myers.
This cat is currently in violation of 17 of your mother's rules. 18!
The Cat in the Hat.
Humana, humana, humana. Who is this?
Check it out.
That's my mom.
Awkward.
The Cat in the Hat's hat can get a boner. Remember that? Remember? I think that was a London bit. The Cat in the Hat's hat can get a boner.
Somewhere in the dark underworld, there is a plan. A plan to
what is this?
Mankind. Now. The world's most elite organization must step forward.
What could this possibly be?
Search the globe for evil, scour the continents for danger, and what they discover will turn the world upside down.
Plant him around.
Lower Looney Tunes back in action. A rabbit, a duck, a girl, a boy.
You. This movie is 10 times better than Space Jam, at least. I saw this in the theater and I liked it a lot. And that was before I knew that Joe Dante directed it.
Who has dynamite?
Welcome to my world.
Looney Tunes back in action.
Now that's funny. That's a George Wood line. Oh yeah, okay. That was a 35mm scan by a fella named Dennis.
Mrs. Santa?
That was her sister.
Oh no.
I gotta look it up, I'm sorry.
It's in the shop.
Where's the reindeer?
I stable them.
Where's the stable?
Next to the shop.
How do they sleep?
Are you messing with me?
There's something about the guy that makes me uneasy.
I forgot that John Ritter was in this.
Each other a lesson.
Is that your
I like this movie.
Where is the rest of it? Actually, I don't want to know.
Directed by Terry Zwigoff.
Learn to stand up for yourself.
It's follow up to Ghost World.
Scream! Be loud!
You don't hit enough.
What's wrong with you? He's just a kid.
I told you I didn't want to do this.
Scrolling through my subs. Dennis Carl Robidoux. He scans 35mm trailers. With some sort of homemade Raspberry Pi device.
I beat up some kids today, but it's for a purpose. Made me feel good about myself.
Yeah, this is almost it. This is almost it. Okay.
The eye of the enemy is moving.
This is the third and final in the trilogy of the Lord of the Rings. It's called like Return of the Dude. I think it's like called Return the Dude Returns. I think it's called Max Dugan Returns.
This is your test. You have trod through wilderness through war.
I really don't like these movies, and I saw the first one on video, and I was like playing on my computer while it was on. Not really paying that much attention to it, but I liked it based on half watching it. So I got excited to go see the second one in theaters, and I left 90 minutes in because I realized I had 90 more minutes. And when I first got a Blu-ray player, and I was working at the video store, and I didn't have a lot of Blu-rays, and I just was really getting into the idea of just watching movies on Blu-ray. So I went to the Wikipedia page for Lord of the Rings. And I remember thoroughly reading the Wikipedia for Lord of the Rings, clicking on sublinks, reading about like what orcs were. Like I did a shitload of homework. Cause there's never a chance I was gonna read the books. But I read so much Wikipedia context. You know, anything outside of like a like, you know, straight up spoiling the story, but I read everything about, like, the universe and how, like, you know, things worked, how there's wizards and stuff. And then I watched all three movies, and it none of it, I don't think any of it helped at all. You do kind of feel happy for the hobbits, though, at the end. You're like, there is a little bit of, like, oh, good for those little guys. It's, you know, it's like not that bad of a thing to be, you know, good, feel good about some little guys. This is arguably the last good Tim Burton movie. That's fun. That's like in Martin. Remember Martin? Remember when Martin, there was like a woman who gave birth and the baby shot out? And then Martin caught it. And then Tommy was like, where's the umbilical cord? And then Martin said, we don't need no umbilical cord. This is TV. Very formative joke. I just saw Albert Finney in Wolfen. Didn't like it that much, but it, you know, it was a pretty movie. If you like old New York stuff, it's enjoyable on that level. But I found it very boring. I remember I saw this with a couple of friends, and they were very moved by this movie, and they were, like, crying, and I remember pretending to cry. Because this movie did not make me cry, and I felt like maybe I was being unkind by not crying with my friends. So I kind of pretended like I was also crying a little bit. Doesn't always make sense, but that's what kind of story this is. Okay. This will be the last video. This is the closing credits of our movie tonight. Yeah, this rules. This legitimately rules. I love this song. And I love this performance. I know, Con. I know. It's important for me to state that Lindsay Lohan in real life is only 3 years younger than me. And you know what I never noticed before is that there's a chubby boy in the band. I mean, I saw this movie, so I probably, like, understood, had a bit better grasp on the world. But I've watched this video before, like, repeatedly. And this viewing, I made note of the chubby boy in the band, because he was probably ecstatic to be in a band. Imagine you're that chubby boy, and you're in a band with the hottest girl on earth. He does have big pants. Waiting all my life for someone just like you. You're it. You're the ultimate you. Yeah. This rules. Well, this was fun. I might do more of these. I just like the idea of showing trailers on Twitch and getting people to chat. I mean, I don't think this is going to replace our normal Friday night thing, but you know. And I just put this on at the end to run out the clock with. Yeah, I'm glad you made it, Brandon. I hope you're feeling better. And yeah, well, I'll try to come up with more like thematic trailer shows, and we can just get on and talk about movies and shit. And yeah, maybe I'll win an Oscar for this someday, huh? Maybe I'll get a Lifetime Achievement Award for this Twitch stream at some point, at some juncture. All right, good night, everybody. Let's all watch a motion picture from 2003 and report back. All right, and I'll come up with another time to do this. We should probably do it maybe on, like, I don't know, like a different weeknight. Maybe, you know, something snappy. All right, good night.